Imagine I'm hosting a barbecue and I just ran out of burgers. I'm gonna go on an app, order some more, and within 10 minutes, it's gonna come to my backyard in this drone. This isn't just some hypothetical. This is happening right now in Texas.
Zipline is quietly running one of the most advanced autonomous delivery systems on Earth. They're partnering with Chipotle and Walmart to drop your burritos or batteries into your backyard. And this isn't just coming soon, it's happening now. And they could scale this service across the country. They've already flown over 120 million miles. That's the same as driving every road in America 28 times. And it's done all of this with zero injuries.
Let's just say I work at Walmart, someone just ordered this and I need to send it out for dispatch. I'm gonna put it in this little box here. I'm gonna place it there. I'm gonna close it, and now it's ready for delivery. It's gonna be dispatched, basically gonna go into the belly of the aircraft, and it's ready to be delivered.
Since launching in Dallas, Zipline has been expanding fast, about 15 to 20% week over week, and it's serving tens of thousands of homes. Here's what happens when you place an order. A lightweight aircraft takes off from a local distribution center. It climbs around 300 feet, flies autonomously to your address, and when it arrives, a small delivery pod, what they call the Zip, descends quietly on a cable and sets your order down in your backyard or your driveway, and then it pulls the line back up and heads home. This whole trip can take as little as 10 minutes.
They want to minimize the weight here so they can maximize the space that goes inside the box so that you can deliver as much as possible in this box.
Each aircraft runs 500 safety checks every second and adjusts its position every 20 milliseconds. That's 5 times faster than a human blink. Oh, also it flies in rain, wind, heat, whatever, constantly learning from every delivery. Not only is it delivering stuff to your yard, it's also saving lives by partnering with hospitals, but more on that later. I've come to Zipline's experimental test site in Half Moon Bay, California. These engineers are simulating every possible scenario that a drone might face in the real world.
So the idea here is to test research and development in terms of what happens when the drone is experiencing someone that put a lawn chair in the area that it is supposed to deliver the package. And this is really cool to see a testing facility that like looks like these mock-up homes and these mock-up backyards. This is the delivery Zip, and one thing that's pretty shocking to me is how light this is. When you see it from a distance, it looks like it's a pretty heavy-duty, heavy metal thing that's made of plastic, but it's actually made of a styrofoam-like substance, kind of like what you have on a helmet, a bike helmet. What's really unique about this is it has a fan on the back and then thrusters here, and this is to help it navigate. Let's say if it's a windy day, it can actually drop from the line and the fan here can help it go left, right, center, things like that. And this is done to avoid different objects that maybe you don't see coming, a squirrel, a dog, or a package that's already in your front yard.
So this is our obstacle course. So this is where we try to put our delivery Zip to its limit to figure out what type of weird backyards it can handle. We view this as probably more complex than a typical backyard that you would see out here, but we want to prove that it can handle anything and it will avoid anything that a consumer puts out in their backyard.
Employees even bring their dogs to work to see how animals will react to the drone.
We have our Zip delivering right next to our employees' dogs, seeing how the dogs react, and also seeing that the Zip actually avoids the dogs.
Each drone uses a full sensor suite, not just cameras, to detect things like telephone wires, string lights, trees.
We test with flying by wires, telephone wires, things of that nature, because those are a common thing that you see in an American backyard.
Zipline's engineers have spent over 1 million hours testing and refining every detail of the hardware and software. And it's not so much about flying faster, but more about flying safer.
This is the charging point, and this is where the aircraft will come and charge up and also get deliveries that can go out for dispatch. But one thing you'll notice is this is quite a big setup. You need a pretty good amount of space to host all of these aircraft, and that's not gonna work if you wanna be like next to a Chipotle or outside of a Wendy's or something. So that's why they've created this. They can even develop this inside a building. So imagine my kitchen is here. I can literally have a zipping point in my kitchen and make sure that the food is delivered fresh out of the oven or off the stove or whatever, straight into the zipping point. So after I put the food in the zipping point, ready for delivery, let me go outside to show you what happens next. This is what it looks like. As you'll notice, it's relatively small and it looks kind of interesting. So let's see how exactly this works. Let's summon a drone to come pick up the package.
But hold on, what about the economics here? Isn't it expensive to run all these flights?
For Chipotle right now, it is $2.99 as a delivery fee. and then 10% of the cost of the order capped out at $6. So we already find that we're really competitive with other traditional, you know, ground delivery services.
Because the cost is mainly electricity and maintenance, the economics here only improves as they scale. So the more they fly, the cheaper each delivery becomes. So I mentioned they're already scaling in Dallas, but they're also planning to expand to other markets like Seattle and Arkansas. When we thought about autonomous, we used to just think about cars driving themselves, but now the sky is becoming autonomous. But before Zipline started delivering food and shopping items, there was a much bigger mission here.
Zipline started only doing medical delivery. The very first use case was delivering blood in Rwanda just to a single hospital. At the very beginning, we were able to cut the average time from, you know, hours, you know, 6-7 hours, down to just about 30 minutes. From that beginning, we now serve more than 5,000 hospitals around the world.
In Ghana, maternal mortality at hospitals that are served by Zipline have dropped by 56%. In Rwanda, cases of severe child malnutrition have dropped by 80%. They've delivered 25 million doses of vaccines and countless emergency supplies. So what began as life-saving logistics for remote hospitals is now evolving into a delivery network that now moves groceries, medicine, animal care products, and even car parts. And across much of sub-Saharan Africa, geography has always been one of healthcare's biggest challenges. See, roads can be washed out by rain, hospitals are spread far apart, and rural clinics are operating with very little resources. So before Zipline, something as simple as a bag of blood or a tetanus vaccine could take hours or even days to reach a patient. For many, that would be too late. So these operations are also now reshaping how governments think about public health logistics. Ministries of health now integrate Zipline into their national supply chain to make sure that vaccines, blood, and medicines are replenished automatically. It's becoming a model that's being studied by global health organizations as a blueprint for last mile delivery, especially in developing nations. Okay, maybe the most remarkable thing about all this is how these small red and white aircraft have changed public perception of technology. See, in rural villages, children now recognize the buzzing sound of a Zipline drone as a sign of hope, proof that someone, somewhere, cares enough to reach them. And in a region long defined by logistical challenges, Africa's partnership with Zipline is becoming kind of like a symbol of what's possible when innovation meets necessity.
We see this service being used in pretty much any metro area around the country. We're able to serve really high density areas. Long term, we absolutely think we could be delivering to rooftops, to balconies, these things. We're not there just yet today, but the technology itself is more than capable of doing so.
So yes, the same drones that deliver blood across Africa are now dropping off burritos in Texas.
The people who actually use our service the most, we're finding, are actually older adults, people with mobility issues, single parents, anyone who really is too busy.
For them, a 10-minute autonomous delivery is about independence. So now a parent that has a sick child doesn't have to load them into a car to go to a pharmacy. An older adult can get a prescription without waiting for a ride. Every flight is electric and emission-free, and that reduces road traffic and delivery van pollution. And because the aircraft stay 300 feet in the air and the delivery zip descends quietly, a lot of times you may not even notice it when it arrives.
Yeah, one of the absolute crucial parts of the delivery experience and the customer experience is that we don't want you to even hear it when it shows up. So the aircraft is flying at 300 feet, and it lowers the delivery zip, which is very quiet. And that way it mitigates the sound and it makes it just a quiet, nice experience in your neighborhood.
At first I was pretty skeptical of this whole drone delivery thing, but now I've changed my mind. Here's why.
Autonomous delivery is not just about speed. It's about rethinking how goods move through a city and who gets access to them. When you look up at the sky, it might still seem empty, but right now, above neighborhoods across Texas, drones are quietly delivering meals, medicines, and groceries hundreds of times a day.
All right, if you're enjoying this channel, make sure to check out my new channel. It's Uptin and Thomas.
Twice a week, Tuesdays and Fridays, Uptin and I are talking about business, tech, trends, culture, politics, anything and everything that's happening this week.
It's super timely because, you know, a lot of times with YouTube, you have to wait a few weeks to get something out, but this is meant, we're recording the same day that we drop it. This is a way to get all your news you need in tech and economics and business within 20 to 30 minutes, although sometimes you talk a lot more than that.
Not just news, you also get our differing opinions and our hot takes on everything going on.
And not all the times we agree. In fact, we disagree quite often. You can find us on YouTube where we're dropping our episodes twice a week and also daily shorts on the YouTube channel. We're also on Spotify, Apple, and Amazon.
Anywhere you find your podcasts.
We'll see you there.